My dear elegant ladies, welcome back to my channel. Why do you think that some women who end up looking quite inappropriate, poorly dressed, and sometimes even quite tacky, why do you think they look like that? Well, because they don't know these 10 styling rules that I'm about to present to you. And as you know, ladies, I am a certified image and color consultant, and I have learned some really important styling tips that I'm gonna share with you today. And ladies, if you want to learn more about how to become an elegant woman, then make sure you click the subscribe button here below so that you don't miss out on every video that I release on Sundays. And make sure you visit annabay.com to find out more on how you can work together with me so that I can help you with your personal transformation. Now let's start with styling tip number one. Styling rule number one is to always wear nude and seamless underwear whenever you wear light color garments. Ladies, let's get the biggest and most common styling mistake out of the way, shall we? Because I want you to stop wearing those white underwear or those contrasting colorful underwear whenever you wear light colored clothing. Because hello, we can see them. And the same goes for wearing textured underwear like lace bras or lace panties under delicate or like sheer fabrics. Because the texture is going to be visible under such fabrics. And if you have ever worked in the fashion industry, you will know that there is a reason to why all models who come to a shoot or a catwalk always must wear underwear and bras in their skin color and that are seamless. Because underwear should not be visible. This is a rule every elegant woman must follow, because as soon as underwear becomes visible, the elegance immediately disappears. And I don't want you to make this mistake. Styling rule number two is to always wear lipstick that matches your skin undertone. And ladies, all of us, regardless of our skin color, we all have an undertone. It's going to be either a warm undertone, a cool, or a neutral tone. Now, a question to you. What is your skin undertone? And if the answer is, I don't know, then shame on you, my dear elegant lady, because every woman must know her skin undertone. This is the mere basics of doing your makeup and dressing your clothes. You have to know these things. But how do we know this? Well, just take out your wrist, take a look on the veins inside here, and see what color they are. Do they appear to be more blue or green? If your veins appear to be more blue, then you are going to be cool toned. If you see more green, then you are warm toned. But if you see a fair amount of both green and blue, then you are a neutral undertone. So ladies, once you know your undertone, you always have to wear your lipstick in that undertone. If you are warm, make sure your lipstick has a warm undertone. If you're cool, your lipstick has to have a cool undertone. And the lucky ladies who have a neutral undertone, they can actually wear both. Now, styling rule number three is to always look at yourself in the mirror from every angle before leaving your home. And ladies, I'm talking about your clothes, your hair, your makeup, because you're not aware about how you look from the side or from the back. And there might be something there that you're not seeing, like, let's say, how strange a garment looks or sits from the side, or maybe your foundation that you didn't really blend properly here. You need to really see from the side how it looks like. Or maybe you have, I don't know, something with your hair going on back there that you're not noticing. So this is really important and why you must invest in several mirrors and always have a proper check before you leave that door. Because this way, you will never run the risk of committing any of these really awful elegance mistakes that I see so many women do. And oh, by the way, there is still a little bit of time left to join my free workshop where I give you 10 more of those really scary elegance mistakes that I see so many people do. And you know, after this workshop, you will learn how to immediately correct these elegance mistakes so that you never have to look like you are out of place ever again. So to join this free workshop, just go to elegancemistakes.com and sign up, and hurry up because soon this workshop is going to disappear. Styling rule number four is to find your signature style for days when you don't want to think about what to wear. Don't we have many of those sometimes? Ladies, a good example is actually someone like Anna Wintour or even Steve Jobs, perhaps a little bit extreme example, or maybe even myself. The Anna Bay signature white pant and colorful top look is something that I wear on days when I'm really in a hurry and I have zero time to think about putting together an interesting outfit. And I think that we all can relate to how time-consuming styling yourself can be. And for this reason, it's essential for everyone to find at least one outfit that becomes their style uniform, because you will need it for days like this. And ladies, this foolproof go-to look that you have to create, it has to be first and foremost elegant, it has to flatter you and your body shape, and it also really needs to work for most occasions. And there it should be sitting in your wardrobe on standby for days when you really don't have time or don't have energy to think about what to wear. And it's really going to save you many times in the future, so make sure you create one for yourself. Styling rule number 5 is to be on the lookout for those loose threads. And yes, I want you to turn yourself into Inspector Gadget when you scan your garments. Because ladies, you really need to police all of your garments for any of those loose threads that might be poking up and ruining your elegant look. And oftentimes when you buy a garment, especially at fast fashion stores, where the quality of finish isn't always good, Zara, and ladies, you need to pay close attention to those threads, even actually when you go to high quality clothing stores, because it does happen pretty much everywhere. So make sure that becoming Inspector Gadget is now part of your new fashion routine. Styling rule number 6 is to always coordinate the colors in the pattern garments that you're wearing. And I know that many ladies find it really tricky to wear patterns because you might be worried on how to really style the rest of the outfit without ending up looking a bit like a clown. And the key to looking elegant when you wear those patterns is to always wear colors of the pattern in the rest of your outfit. So you don't want to mix and match and start wearing all kinds of other colors that are not inside the pattern. It's about making sure that the rest of the outfit has the same colors as this exact pattern. This way it looks really coordinated, it unites the whole look, and you can really let loose. If you have a pattern, let's say with 3 different colors, you can wear all of those 3 colors in your entire look without it looking strange. Now, styling rule number 7 is to add a little bit of pop of color when you feel like you're looking a little bit too plain in the mirror. And ladies, you know that I love simple and classic outfits where being plain is actually what sometimes brings out the elegance in look. However, we all have those days when we look at the outfit in front of us and we just feel that, something here is missing. And sometimes the trick is to really just add a little bit of accessories or a pop of color. So let's say you're wearing a plain white dress. If you wear a matching white bag to it, it's gonna look really plain and boring. But let's say you add a little red bag or a blue bag, then all of a sudden you spice the outfit up and it looks more interesting. Styling rule number 8 is to always take care of your shoes and bags. And ladies, on this channel, we want to look elegant, we want to look expensive, so for us, it's a massive no-no to wear scuffed shoes and bags, because it immediately downgrades an entire look. And for bags, you have to pay attention to some things. First of all, the bag cannot look really tired and worn out. Now, it is normal that the edges can have a little bit of scuffing going on, that's fine. But when those marks start to become really big, that's when you really need to pay attention. Same goes, ladies, if you have those threads poking up that I just mentioned from the stitching of the bag, or if, let's say, you have some visible stains. Now, when it comes to shoes, ladies, we have to think about no obvious color marks or lines on the shoes, and also that your heel and your soles are intact. Nothing can look worn out. And also, let's say you're wearing sneakers, pay attention to those white laces because you don't want them to look gray instead of white. And you see, ladies, details like this go a really long way. So don't be a little misneglector, because that is not elegant. Now, styling rule number 9 is to shop for your current size, not for a smaller size that you think you're gonna have one day. Because this is such a common mistake that so many women do. They think that going one size a little bit too small, because deep down you think that, oh, you know, I'm starting this new diet, so I'm gonna lose weight in the future, might as well shop for that size. And I really think it's so important to buy for the size that you are today, because we have spoken on this channel so much how essential the fit of the garment is. And what happens when you wear a garment that is a little bit too small for you, you're actually going to look bigger. Your garment must have the appropriate fit for your body, because otherwise, ladies, all of these styling tips that I'm giving you are really just pointless. Styling tip number 10 is to always show off your waist. And ladies, stop hiding your waist with oversized clothing and bulky sweaters or whatever, because you know what happens? You're gonna look bigger, bulkier, and heavier than you actually are. But whenever you accentuate your natural silhouette, whether it is with a belt or with specific garments that are built in a little bit of waist, then you are going to look slimmer and more feminine, and of course also more elegant as a result. But I'm actually sharing more of these tips to you in my next video, 5 fashion rules every woman must know. I will see you in that video.